That wouldn't work, would you?
She's here today, ready to go. I want to introduce you to Sue and Ashley.
You've seen this?
Until 2:30, and y'all go get amped up for the Super Bowl, right?
Youth breakfast will be Saturday, February 10th at 8 o'clock in the morning. The Heaven Saints Motorcycle Ministry will meet on Friday, February the 9th. That is this Friday upcoming. See Pastor Dano for more information. And last but not least, the annual marriage retreat on April 13th through the 15th, right before tax season. Right? So last couple days of Florida, you need to file your taxes. That will be April 13th through the 15th at Ridgecrest Conference Center. The cost is $250 per couple. If you're interested in that, see Ms. Courtney or Mr. David, or you can see Pastor Gene or Pastor Bill. All right, well, let's have a good time with the Lord this morning. Then go ahead and stand on your feet. The Word says, I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Amen. Amen. Well, let's go ahead and go to the Lord in prayer, and then we'll get started with worship. Father, we thank you for this day. God, we are so grateful that we got to witness a baptism just now, God, and somebody that chose to, God, go full in, go all out for you, Father God. And we just thank you, Lord, for this recent salvation. We thank you, Lord, for the baptism that just occurred, and we pray your blessings upon her life, upon her family's life. We pray your provision. We pray your guidance, and we pray for us as we continue to disciple her, Father God, in your steps. God, we just pray, God, in Jesus' name, that you bless today's service, that you bless the worship, that you bless each and every aspect of the service, God, each and every ministry, children's ministry, youth ministry, Father, and bless Pastor Billy, God, as he brings forth your word today. We love you, we praise you, we thank you for what you're going to do. We come with an expectant heart for what you're doing here at Life Church, Father. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. And the whole church said,
Amen.
Amen. This wants you a fellowship, shake hands for about 30 seconds to a minute, and then we'll get started with worship. Thank you. Come on, help us out, Mr. Lord. Put your hands together like this.
Thank you. Thank you. You are the God of all power. Yeah. raise your hand. We've got some people here. I get phone calls real quick because I can't be here Sunday. I've got the flu. And I know Pam, her husband. Nancy just got, Susan just got baptized. Had to go home because she was sick. She came. She said, I'm baptized today. But she went back because she was still having running the temperature. She's gone back. I want to continue to pray for Linda. Dano, he texted me. He's sick for the flu. So I want us to take authority this morning. And as a pastor, I want to take authority over this sickness upon our manager, our father here. And so if you know somebody, if somebody wants to stand in the ground, you know, if you know somebody in the congregation, in our body here, I want you to raise your hand and say, I'm going to stand in for them. For Susan, for Pam. Raise your hand. And if you're fighting something right now, you're fighting something, maybe some kind of injury or something like that, you want to pray for you, so raise your hand and keep your hand up. I want the rest of us to come, and I'm going to pray and lead us. I want y'all to come with us. Gather around these that you see hands up. And we're going to lay hands. We're going to believe God this morning. We either do or we don't believe God. I'm going to say we do. Healing is here, church. Healing is here. Do we believe it? Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Hold some more together around, man. Others that you just need one or two of them. Come together and believe. Brothers and sisters, we need you praying together. You young people, come on. Get involved. Glory to your name. Jesus, in your mighty name, we come before you. We come before the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We come before the healer of our life, who has all power to heal. And so this morning, Father, in the glorious name of Jesus, those who are with us here and those who are at home that's fighting this flu, we come against that flu now in Jesus' name. We're believing right now, Father, for temperatures to get back normal. In Jesus' name. Now, so the hotness cools down. The sickness begins to go away. Well, we know this. They don't have to be here right among us. The word sees where Jesus is praying. People at home for him. And we're believing that today, Father, in Jesus' name. That they are healed. We come against this blue blood, whatever it is. We come against it. We claim victory today in healing in the mighty name of Jesus. We believe healing right now, Father. May it flow through glory right now, Father, in Jesus' name. Whatever muscle, whatever it is that's causing the pain, Father God, let a healing take place in her life right now in Jesus' name. Let it come forth. Let the anointing flow in, through it, and in her, Father God. Glory to your name, Father. Glory to your name. Fathers, we've been teaching about the big church. Lord, we believe that they lay hands on each other. That they came together and lay hands. And healing take place. About that place, Father. So we believe in signs and wonders. We believe the manifestations of the Holy Spirit of healing, Father God. We know faith is a gift that is given to us. And we speak that faith right now, Father. In Jesus' name. It is time for God's people to receive the victory that belongs to them, Father. No longer will the devil rob God's children of their blessings. Glory to your name, Father. Father, right now, I lift that is struggling with addictions right now, Father, in Jesus' name. I've come against that stronghold in their life right now, in Jesus' name. I pray that they're set free today. Set free of whatever it is that's bounding them down, that's keeping them doing the same thing over and over. Today, may they receive the victory in Jesus' name. Devil, you're a liar. You're a thief. And no longer will you rob God's children of their blessings. Oh, hallelujah, Jesus. Thank you, Father God. Let your anointing of healing just begin to flow in this place, Father God, in Jesus' name. From little injuries to big injuries. Let it flow. Make muscles begin to heal up. Bones begin to heal up. Bone spurs to go away in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Glory to your name.
Thank you.
be life and life more abundant. Will you not start walking in that abundance is yours? It's time for my children to quit walking with their heads down and for their heads to be walking up, not looking to the world for answers, but looking unto me for the answers. For I have the answers of life. I have the answers to victory. I have the answers that you need to know. But you have to look at me. You have to spend time with me. And I will tell you the secrets that I have for you. I will lay forth the promises that I have for you. I will give you that which belongs to you. But seek my face. Trust me. Believe in me. For I am your healer. I am your answers to life. Trust me. Walk in victories. For they are yours. But look unto me. Look unto me, my children. Can you not feel the love that I have for you? For I wrap my arms around you every day to tell you how much I love you. Will you not? Will you begin to feel that love? Will you begin to feel my arms around you daily, loving on you? For I do not bring you defeat, I bring you victory. I bring you those things that you need, not want. But I say, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And all these other things will be your righteousness. But will you seek me with a whole heart? Know my voice. Will you not know me? Glory to your name, Jesus. We come here, Father, we are amazed at what you're doing among us. Even now, you have each and every one of us in your arms. Today, there are victories that have taken place in this house. There are victories that have taken place in homes. Because what is going on here, Father? Because of the faith that's been lifted up here. And we give you all the praise and all the glory and all the honor. We know man did not do it, but you do it, Father God. We just are obedient in what you want us to do. Be with us throughout this service, Father God. That you're healing us. Not just physically, Father God. Lord, you're healing us spiritually. You're healing us mentally, Father God. You're healing us financially, Father God. Because you want the best for your children. You want that perfect gift for your children, Father God. And the perfect gift has already been given to us, and that's Jesus Christ. And I thank you, Lord Jesus, what you did on that cross for us. And that you're sitting beside the Father, interceding for us, even now. And so we thank you, we praise you, we glorify you, Father. In your name we pray. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Can we continue in this atmosphere of tithes and offerings this morning? Glory to you, God. Hallelujah. Father, as we come, we give today, Father God. We do not give the organization, we do not give the man, we give unto you, Father God. And I thank you that you're meeting every need in this house, Father God. Every need in this house, the bills, the things that we have to. That you're bringing finance and blessing upon your children and their homes, Father God. I pray their needs will be met. And we'll be sure to give you the praise and the honor for them, Father. As they come forth in you today, Father, we thank you for this great time together. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. So as you come, give love on somebody this morning. Ask them, say, did you receive your healing this morning? Did you receive the blessing God had for you this morning? Amen? So let me count four.
Friday night. I've asked Pastor Dora from
El Shaddai to come and speak on Saturday night. Sunday morning, we got Pastor Rick Welch, who, you know, does the drawings. He's going to be here one minute tonight, Sunday night, powerful man of God. He's going to come on Sunday morning. Then on Sunday night, I got Pastor John Lawton from C3 Covenant Community Church. He's going to come in and finish it off on Friday night. Four spirit-filled, on fire for God pastors. Now, and when I found out, I didn't have to go out of state. I didn't have to go to some big, you know, to bring in what we want, what God wants us to have here. Four local pastors that has a heart for God. And so I'm believing for the gifts of the Holy Spirit. I'm believing for manifestations of the Holy Spirit to take place. And I told them, I said, just let go and let God.
Amen.
And so we're going to have a great time. And it's going to be open up the community. It's going to be on Sunday, Friday night, Saturday night. Sunday night will be 6:30. But the other nights will be 7 o'clock. And then Sunday morning, regular service. So we're going to be getting some flyers to hand out so you can take them out and hand them out to people. And like I said, it's calling a spiritual awakening. I ain't fancy with the names. This is the It's just spiritual awakening because it's time for the church to wake up. It's time for Christians to wake up. It's time for us to begin to do what God's called us to do. And we've got to do it. We've got to get the word outside. So, that's coming up. And I'm excited about it. I've been talking to Wayne about how we can do a youth conference here. You know, he just went to a youth conference. I'm like, why can't we do one here? And Pastor Young, we've got a youth pastor in his life that are on fire for God. And so we're going to be doing some stuff here in 2018 that God wants us to do. Amen? Hallelujah. Big congregation or big audience? That's the message today. You know, though, when we think of big congregation, we think the church. Because the congregation is just basically a gathering of people. An audience, if you look in the Webster Dictionary, is people coming together to listen to a speaker or a concert or a play. And how many know that in the other room there's a congregation going on, people praying. But where were the audience? Outside. And the people did what? They listened to what was being said. You don't see too many congregations listening to what's being said. Because biggest time is they sleep halfway through it. Because they stayed up all night, Saturday night before. Or they're bored with the speaker. So, I'm going to put me a little ball up there. When I see someone sleep, I'm going to give him an A. So be wary if I see them eyes closing. No. But I mean, sometimes it gets hot in here and stuff like that, but how do you know when people go to an audience and these go